Lorenzo Romano Amedeo Carlo Avogadro was born on 9 August 1776 in Turin, Piedmont-Sardinia, into a noble family in the Kingdom of Sardinia, now part of Italy. His parents were distinguished Italian lawyers, and his father, Filippo Avogadro, was a well-known magistrate and senator in the Piedmont region of northern Italy. His mother, Anna Vercellone of Biella, was a noble woman. Avogadro was a bright young man who did excellently in his studies. Being the child of a lawyer, he decided to follow his father's footsteps and studied law. He graduated from jurisprudence in 1792. Avogadro continued with his doctorate study in law, and 4 years later, when he was only 20, he received his doctorate in ecclesiastical law. After graduation, he began to practice his legal career and became the secretary to the prefecture of Eridano in 1801. Soon after, Avogadro gradually began to lose interest in legal matters. He believed science was much more intellectually stimulating and began to develop interest in physics and mathematics. Referred to as positive philosophy then, he began to study these subjects privately under the tutelage of the prominent mathematical physicist, Professor Vasali Iandi. Avogadro soon began to conduct his scientific researches with his main focus on electricity. In 1803, Avogadro worked together with his brother, Felix, to publish his first scientific paper. The paper focused primarily on the electrical behavior of salt solutions. In 1804, he quitted his legal practice after realizing that he was meant for a scientific career. He also became a corresponding member of the Academy of Sciences of Turin. In 1806, Avogadro moved into academics and began to teach physics and mathematics at a high school in Vercellone, Turin. In 1809, Avogadro became a professor of natural philosophy at the Royal College of Vercellone. He maintained this post until 1820. One day, while Avogadro was experimenting with gas densities in Vercellone, he noticed something amazing. He combined two volumes of hydrogen gas with one volume of oxygen gas, and two volumes of water vapor were produced. Considering his understanding of gas densities at the time, he was expecting the combination to yield only a volume of water vapor and not two. However, the experiment led him to conclude that the oxygen particles consisted of two atoms. He used the word molecule then. Avogadro also described three different types of molecules in his writings. The integral molecules, which are very similar to our present-day molecules, constituent molecules, these form part of an element, and elementary molecules, which are very similar to what we refer to as atoms now. His study on elementary molecules highly influential in the field of atomic theory. Avogadro was not the only scientist in the field of molecules and gases. There were two other scientists, French chemist Joseph Gay Lussac and English chemist John Dalton, who also explored these topics around the same time. Avogadro was greatly influenced by the works of Gay Lussac and Dalton. Avogadro stated that he remembered Dalton for articulating the basics of atomic theory, that all matter is composed of tiny, indivisible particles called atoms. He remembered Gay Lussac for his eponymous gas pressure temperature law. Avogadro began to make his major contribution to the scientific world in 1811, when he stated what was considered to be his biggest contribution to date, the molecular theory, known as Avogadro's law. The law states that equal volumes of all gases at the same temperature and pressure contain the same number of molecules. Avogadro was also able to explicitly explain the Joseph Louis Gay-Lussac's law of combining volumes of gases using his law. That same year, he also discovered the correct molecular formula for hydrogen chloride, carbon monoxide, ammonia, nitrous oxide, and water. He was credited to have established the existence of monoatomic, triatomic, and tetratomic elementary molecules. He was reportedly the first scientist to discover that elements can also exist in the forms of molecules and not always as individual atoms. He also proposed a constant, which was named after him, the Avogadro constant, which is the number of constituent particles, usually atoms or molecules, that are contained in the amount of substance given by one mole. The constant was experimentally determined to be 6.023, times 10.023 molecules per gram mole. Avogadro received the first chair of mathematical physics in 1820 at the University of Turin. He furthered his scientific research, and in 1821 he came up with the correct molecular formula for ether and alcohol. In 1822, Avogadro lost his job at the University of Turin. The university was closed down due to civil disturbances. Very little is known about Avogadro's private life, other than he was a pragmatic, sober, and private man. He was quietly religious. He married at a much older age, 39 years, though some claimed he was 42 years when he married. He got married to Felicia Mazze. The couple had six children, all sons. Avogadro died on 1856 at the age of 76. He died in Turin, Piedmont, Sardinia. Avogadro was a very hardworking and modest person who did not receive much commendation for his scientific work during his lifetime. Most of his scientific contributions were recognized many years after his death. Thank you. Thank you very much for watching our videos. We'd like to give you another interesting video for you to enjoy next. Well, before then, our team will be very happy if you can like this video and share it with your friends on social media. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss other interesting videos like this. Look at your screen now to see two other interesting videos we handpicked for you to enjoy next. We love you.